Eons old, the Great Plains sweep majestically across the very heart of America. These rolling hills offer a diverse habitat to a bewildering array of plants and wildlife alike. The most peculiar of these inhabitants is the Kansas Jayhawk. Indigenous to the Midwest, the colorful fowl is thought mythical by many. Most who have actually encountered the bird in the wild, however, will only mention that they wish it did not exist. Adorned in blue feathers and topped with a head of the brightest crimson, the Jayhawk spends its day nonsensically hunting for chalky rocks and waving weed strands without reason. Our feathered friend has many natural predators. Bears, frogs, and even cattle have been known to tear into these birds in the wild. The most ferocious of these enemies, however, is the wildcat. Possessing the wisdom of a scheming savant, cunning stealth, and the sort of agility rarely encountered in nature, the feline stalks his prey with a sniper's silence. Now, just feet from his foe, the wildcat could end it quickly. His speed is unmatched, his wits are unrivaled. With one predatory pounce, the proverbial band could strike up happy trails. Instead, the wildcat chooses to make a game of it. He circles the perimeter. He faces the helpless, mindless bird. Their eyes meet. Realizing he stares in the face of danger, the Jayhawk takes flight. His best chance for safety lies in the protected area of the meadow called the end zone. Alas, the bird's feeble mind and poor sense of direction often lead to futile attempts at reaching that goal. Nonetheless, the age-old dance begins. At long last, this game of cat and, well, whatever, is over. With this wildcat victory complete, just one thing remains.
Went from running on the wild prairies and doing what you think you do is natural, to being in the grasp of the mask.
I followed him, stalked him all the way through the tree line, found him pecking on some chalky rocks.
He was choking on them, because that's what they do in the field, they choke.
And then I snatched him up like a cat coming after a bird with sneakers on.
Look at you, in my arms, all docile, not scaring me, not worrying anybody. You're like a crazy little chicken with your head cut off, except for this one's got a head. Because we're kosher.
You can shake all you want, you're not getting out of my grasp. Told you, you're not getting out of my grasp. You're not mad, you're slightly agitated. You know who else gets agitated? Predator, in the middle linebacker spot. Gonna hit Chris right up in his face mask.
What, are you falling asleep over here, Mr. Jayhawk? Is it because you're watching your team on offense? Boring?
You having nightmares about Charlie Weiss trying to eat you as a whole chicken? I would too, it's scary.
He's huge.
Everybody thinks that KU's so great with their red and blue. Put them together on the color wheel, what do you get? Purple. You're all closet K-State fans. And once we crush this chicken in this Jayhawk Nation, we're gonna get purple chicken nuggets. That's what we love. And that's what Tyler Lockett eats. Saturday, October 6th, number 7 K-State Wildcats play the, of course, unranked KU Jayhawks, right after the Rooster Crows.
Ugh. Jayhawk tastes horrible. We don't eat it for fun. We eat it to assert our dominance over the other team in Kansas. I wouldn't eat that if my mother forced it down my throat. I love you, Mom. Forgot to mention, John Hubert loves cookies, but Tremaine Thompson loves chicken nuggets. Think you're on it? Welcome to Mickey D's, fool. Oh, God! Oh, man. Oh, God. Oh, man.